Outcome 2.4.4, understand the principles of regenerative circuits. Regeneration is a general term for when exhausting hydraulic fluid from the rod side of an actuator is directed back into the pressure line. The exhausting fluid is reused or regenerated to do work. Interjecting the exhausting fluid into the pressure line adds a resistive load to the actuator so that the increase in available flow results in a decrease in available force. When used on cylinders, it is the rod end exhaust flow that is regenerated back into the blind end flow. This regeneration creates equal pressure on both sides of the piston. Because of the differential area between the blind end and the rod end, the equal pressure produces a greater force on the blind end, causing the cylinder to try to extend. The force caused by the pressure on the annulus area, the area around the rod, acts against some of the force on the piston. Only the pressure acting on the area of the rod is effective in producing force. This actually makes calculating the characteristics of a regenerative circuit quite easy. It is as though the flow and the pressure were acting only on the rod of the cylinder. While it is common to design regenerative circuits using cylinders with a 2-to-1 area ratio between the blind end and rod end, any single rod cylinder can be used for regeneration as long as the force requirements do not exceed what is available from the pressure on the rod area. A simple method of constructing a full-time regenerative circuit is shown in the illustration.
The circuit shown doesn't use the directional control valve B port, but instead connects the rod end port directly to the pump pressure line. For regeneration to work, the rod end area must be smaller than the cap end. Typically, the cap end is approximately twice as large, resulting in an area ratio of approximately 2-to-1. These types of circuits will extend and retract at the same speed. However, only half the normal tonnage extension can be generated. Retraction speed and force are the same as standard non-regen circuits. Regen circuits like these only work on extension. The directional control valve, in its spring offset position, retracts and holds the cylinder in the bottomed out position. This particular set would cause all pump flow to dump over the main relief with some bleeding over the orifice. Shifting the solenoid valve causes the rod flow to loop around and join the pump flow with a small amount being lost over the bleed-off needle valve. When the cylinder bottoms out or stalls due to load, the system pressure builds up to the maximum setting of the main relief valve, while the rod pressure bleeds down to 0 psi. Part-time regen circuit at rest. Retract simply sends pump flow through the counterbalance valve bypass check, and at the same time holds the pilot to close valve closed. When the cylinder starts to extend, it causes oil in the rod side to flow over the check valve to the cap end of the cylinder and increases the speed by adding additional oil flow to the pump flow. The pressure required to move the cylinder requires the counterbalance valve setting to be approximately 200 psi higher. If the cylinder bottoms out while extending or stalls due to load, pressure builds up. Opening the counterbalance valve holds the pilot to close valve closed, and the system builds up to open the system relief valve. Regeneration can be part of the spool configuration. This four-position directional control valve uses solenoids for the three standard positions: neutral, extend, and retract. A manual operator can select the detended regen fourth position. The manual position puts the spool in a regeneration mode. All the oil leaves the rod side and joins the pump flow going into the cap. If the rod end area is half the piston area, the cylinder speed will double. There is no flow going back to tank. The solenoid position above extends the cylinder with all of the pump flow going into the cap end. This position is held with the solenoid energized. The cylinder retracts with all of the pump flow going to the rod area.